Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Rising a Buddhist Vase. This is Nancy from the International Buddha Dharma Society for Cosmic Lawyer America. It's a great honor to be here sharing the pilgrimage trip with you. How are you doing? Today is December 12th, 2020. This will be our last pilgrimage trip with you. And today, we will visit the most famous Jetavana Vihara in Sravasti, the ancient capital city of Kosala. And then we will go to the National Museum of India to visit the Buddha's relics. Jetavana Vihara has different translated names. It's located outside the old city of Sravasti. It was offered to the Buddha by his famous lay disciple Anathapindika. There is a story behind it. It said that after Anathapindika encountered the Buddha, he asked the Buddha to allow him to build a vihara for him and his disciples, which the Buddha agreed. After Anathapindika returned to Sravasti, he began to look for a place for this vihara. He came across a park which was owned by Prince Jeta, the son of Kosala. He wanted to buy this park, but Prince Jeta refused. He joked that if Anathapindika could cover this park ground with golden coins, then he would sell this park to him. Unexpectedly, Anathapindika agreed. He came back with wagons full of golden coins. Prince Jeta was moved by Anathapindika's earnestness. At the end, he donated the forest in the park to the Buddha. So, this vihara is also called Jetavana Anathapindika Vihara. Now let's go to visit this vihara. The Buddha stayed in Jetavana Vihara for 25 raining seasons and gave the most teaching here, such as the Diamond Sutra, the Buddha speaking of Amitabha Sutra, Shangama Sutra, and so on. The Vihara has 12 stupas, 72 lecture halls, 3,600 rooms and 500 pavilions. The main secret places in Jetavana Vihara are the Ananda Bodhi Tree, the Buddha's abode, and the Buddha's preaching platform. It says that the Buddha only lived in Jetavana Vihara 3 months a year during the rainy season. The disciples missed the Buddha, so they asked Ananda to ask the Buddha to plant a Bodhi tree in the Vihara. Ananda pleased the Buddha accordingly, so a Bodhi tree seed was planted by the door of the Vihara and named after Ananda. By the Bodhi tree, people would circumambulate the Bodhi tree and chant the name of the Buddha. After that, they would light incenses and bow to the Bodhi tree to express their respect. Meditate or recite some sutras here also. The trip is close to the end. It's also a good time to transfer the merit accumulated from this pilgrimage trip here. The well in the Vihara is kept very well, and it's a memorable time to drink some water from the well. Walk into the Buddha's abode and meditation room. Though they are just ruins, you can still imagine what they looked like over 2500 years ago. The room is square and the wall is really thick. The Buddha's preaching platform is made of red bricks. The audience would sit on the four sides. It's such a secret place. Don't forget to take some pictures with the Buddha here. One day you may give Dharma talks just like the Buddha. Thus, I have heard, once the Buddha was staying in the Jetavana Vihara, together with a gathering of great disciples, 1,250 in all. Among them are Shariputra, Mahayana, Ananda. This is how many sutras given in Jetavana Vihara started. Leaving Jetavana Vihara, we headed to New Delhi for the returning trip. In the next morning, before going to the airport, we visited the National Museum of India, where the Buddha's relics were in display. If you Google relics on the internet, you will see some beautiful pictures with beautiful, the so-called relics. Often, they are round and even in different colors. People just believe without any doubts. Cheating in Buddhism? No way. But now, let's go to the most authoritative National Museum of India, the most trustable source to see what relics really look like. The 22 pieces of the Buddha's relics are kept in a golden stupa. These relics were excavated from an ancient stupa by Indian archaeologists in 1972, about 22 kilometers away from Lumbini. As stated in the sutra, seeing the relics is seeing the Buddha. The Buddha is still here, feeling the energy around you when you are there. Circumambulate the stupa, chant the name of the Buddha, and meditate for a while. I take refuge in the Buddha. I take refuge in the Dharma. I take refuge in the Sangha. Amitabha, this video ends our pilgrimage trip. I hope this video is helping useful for you. You can take a virtual pilgrimage trip anytime by watching these videos. Learning from the Buddha starts from understanding the Buddha. We always recommend people who are interested in the Buddha and Buddhism read the biography of the Buddha first, and then recite sutras given by the Buddha. Uphold at least the 5 basic precepts laid down by the Buddha. Learning from the Buddha is not just to blindly donate money to any temples or listen to lectures given by anyone. Anyone who is interested in the Buddha and Buddhism should go to the Buddha in person. The books are just there. The sutras are just by the hand. There should be no distance between you and the Buddha. Make sense? Again, thank you everyone for being here with me. It's the end of the year. Have a joyful and blessed holiday season. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to you. Thank you. I'll see you next time. Bye.